coming on screen. If you say purposely selfless, I'm going back.
All right. All right.
You can't be selfless and be haphazard about it.
Right.
Have we got a minute?
Yeah.
Selflessness is so foreign to our natural nature. Have I got a minute?
Yes.
It's just like you never will find a natural leader. We've been talking about natural leaders all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, he's just naturally a leader. No such thing. Leadership is a learned experience. You may have certain kind of characteristics about you, but you have to learn to be a leader. Well, in that same vein, is that you've got to learn how to be selfless. Because many of us, even when we were, if we were to give a testimony this morning, we would and be truthful about it. Is that you would say the first sentence, first I gotta see about myself.
All right.
I don't know where this church is this morning. You've got to be selfless on purpose.
Amen.
You have to almost get up in the morning and say, okay, I'm going to see what I can do for somebody else. don't you see that Ruth had no reason to hang on to Naomi? She had a youth. She was only, if she was in her hometown, she could do and see everything that she had grown up with, and she knew the road.
Yes.
In her own hometown.
Yes.
So what is there that the scripture wants us to see as Ruth walked the life?
All right.
Number one is that she stayed with what she had decided to do. And every time there was a blockade or something that was pushing her in another direction, she said, no, I'm going to stay with you. But that's not the only thing she said. If you're going to be selfless, is that you can't do it by yourself. You've got to have God. So when Naomi said, go on back, and Ruth said, no, stay with you. But you may turn south. So I'm going to stay with you and your God. I wish I had something. Your God will be my God. And your home will be my home. She purposely said, a preacher went to visit a person in the ICU, actually. And he said, sister, how you doing? And she replied, I need to get it. why you think you love the other person.
Yeah.
And we spent some time on that. And you know, the first words that I get out is that from the male or the female, and those are the only two that I married, by the way, and it comes to the fact that the male says, well, it's because of the way she makes me feel. Have You say, democratic process is not a place for you to sit on the sidelines. If you want to change the president, you're going to have to get up and press. If you want to be selfless, and if you want to be a sower for God, is that you can't let every and any little stuff blow you up. I'm sorry, blow you away. One of my greatest fears, it used to be, I haven't got over it. No, don't let me tell you I have. Is timid people who would let any small thing change their mind. Oh, I ain't going back there. Because I do. I just don't know. I'm doing the best that I can. Well, the best that you can may not be what God has given to you as a capacity. It may be, and I've said it several times, even in this church, is that I've given all I have. And when we go to something that you like, is that money comes out from every corner. I wish that had some. I couldn't even see you. I'm preaching what the Lord said.